Hi guys, welcome to the Weird Pick Adventure. Today is the 26th of May 2012 and it's Saturday night and I'm drunk and we've got somebody laughing in the background. Yep, we've got ex-apprentice through Skype. I'm just going to turn him up here so he's not too quiet. Hold on. So it might be, I hope it's hearable, but yeah, this is a drunken edition, I suppose. I've never done this before.
Mate, you changed your mind about turning me up.
I don't know, I thought it was going to be too old at first, but then I decided to turn it off, because my camera speaker, the speakers in the camera are not too great, to be honest, so, yeah. So I'm a bit drunk, so it's something new, so yeah.
Well, I will be. At 1 o'clock in the morning.
And it's also going to be very long as well, I think. Half an hour, maybe.
What's his video? He's got it for a world record.
Gone for a world record on YouTube, yeah. Got it on my...
The longest footloose.
24-hour pickup video.
Well, it's in the 24-hour marathon, guys.
Oh, my God. Oh, anyway, here we go. So I've got... Let's see. We've got 8 PS2 games and 1 PS1 game. I've not been buying PS3 games lately. I've not really seen anything that's really caught my eye, to be honest, price-wise, or, games that really interest me, to be honest. So, these are all, like, charity shop pickups, so,
That's just rude.
That's just rude. So, we'll get on with it, shall we? So, yeah, the first game, the PS1 game, is Heart of Darkness, which is actually a game that I had when I was younger, but for some reason, I found it really difficult when I was young, and... I think my dad sold it, because I don't think he liked it, and I didn't like it, because I got stuck on it, so, so I think he sold it. But this is actually in real good condition, well, the manual is, anyway. The manual is a bit, actually it's got a bit, oh shit.
It's in real good condition, or just the
back. Yeah, it's got it's a bit creased at the side there. And it has a real strong smell of dampness, so yeah.
Thank you.
It's got a smell of dampness. Disc one is really badly scratched. Disc one's really badly scratched, but disc two is actually really good condition, so it looks like someone's played the first disc and used it as a boomerang or whatever, but not used the second disc, so that's awesome. So, it seems to be playing so far. I've completed the first world, and it seems to play okay. So, Heart of Darkness, I guess. Right. Next is another charity shop pickup for the PS2. It is Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh, God. It is Yu-Gi-Oh! Cop Show Monster Coliseum. Yeah.
Da-da-da-da.
Which was also... so you can see that. It was £1.99 as well. This is actually the first PS2 game that I've bought in a while, but doesn't have the manual, surprisingly.
Wah.
Yeah, we've got ex-apprentice doing the sound effects here, so yeah. Thank you for that one. So this is the third Yu-Gi-Oh! Game I own. I've got on the PS1 I've got Forbidden Memories. PS2, I've got Duelist of the Roses, and now I've got this one, which is more like Duelist of the Roses. It's more like Duelist of the Roses than Forbidden Memories, but it's completely different as well. So actually, it took me a bit of getting used to, but once I got used to it, I thought it was pretty enjoyable. Played it for about an hour, and it seemed pretty good. Disc's pretty badly scratched, however, but it seems to work so far. Cop Show Monster Coliseum. I'm glad to add it to the collection, I suppose.
Andrew just wants to play a children's card game.
Spot on. Yeah. And about 3 weeks ago, I took a trip into British Heart Foundation. So, and I got 2 PS2 racing games, actually. I've dropped on the board before.
Great
star. Exactly. So one's a game that one's a game that I used to have on the PS1, but I got rid of it because I moved on to PS2 and I didn't realise I was going to be playing the PS1 games again. But yeah, well. So the first game, this was released. This is the Reebok game, and it was London Racer 2 on the PS2. This was 99p. I've got the funny feeling that some kid owned this game because it's really, you know, it's in a hell of a condition. Look at it. It's in a hell of a condition. Look at this.
Oh my god!
The case is broken, the disc scratched to shit. And
Somebody touched on my game.
What you gonna do? Yeah, it's really bothered scratch. It doesn't actually affect the gameplay, but it affects the commentary, the radio. Because actually the radio is actually pretty humorous, but it skips quite a lot. So yeah, the one thing that I really wanted to buy this game back for is that basically it's, you know, you race through London and Edinburgh. I can't really think of a racing game where you race through Edinburgh, so it's pretty good to get that, you know, that's my hometown, so I'm pretty glad to... yeah, to discover that, to be honest. I didn't actually know that when I was younger for some reason. I must have forgot. So, yeah.
I've never seen a racing game that has a level with Edinburgh in it either, to be honest.
Nah, I don't know why. They never use Edinburgh's. I don't know why. Edinburgh's awesome. Yeah. It's always like London or, you know, places like that. It's never like Edinburgh or Glasgow or places like that.
It's a bit rare. Very rare.
Yeah, it's very rare. Yep.
They used to be games that have countries or places that actually aren't going to be in any other game, such as Edinburgh.
Oh, yeah. I think it's got Las Vegas in it. Yeah, Las Vegas, New York, and Chicago as well. So glad Edinburgh's in it.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. And next,
you've got a collector's item there.
You've got a collector's item there. Pity it skips the woman, the radio skips, though, unfortunately. Bowman's kids scratching their games and using them as bloody boomerangs.
Somebody can stole my game, so I scratched it for him.
Aye, well, probably. Probably did, to be honest.
And the, nobody knows what this reference
is about. Nah, it's a reference from One Nation Racers that we're playing online. Some guy was on the microphone and... Son of a dickhead, electrocuted me!
You will not be watching this video,
I hope not. Anyway, you're probably giving a lot of abuse.
Some kid just referenced me.
Aye, you're giving a lot of abuse. God. So on the same day for 99p as well, I bought Crazy Taxi, which is actually a game that I wanted for a while because it's, yeah, it's supposed to be really fun. It's like an arcade style kind of game, and it's actually a lot of versions. There's PS2, Dreamcast, and PC. There's probably more as well. Probably GameCube as well. I wouldn't be surprised, to be honest. So I wanted it a while, and for 99p, I couldn't resist. This game's pretty bad with scratch as well, but it seems to work so far. And it's got the Offspring in it, which the Offspring's amazing. I really like Offspring. So it comes complete with manual. The manual's in really good condition, but the disc's pretty bad with scratch, like I say. But so far, it's not affected gameplay or you know, audio, so... I can still hear my Offspring music, so that's awesome. I played it for...
I'm a
fanboy, yeah, of Offspring. I love Offspring. Offspring, man, they're awesome.
Offspring.
That's the benefit of being drunk, you can't even talk properly. Which is probably a good thing. Anyway, I played it for about 30 minutes, and personally, I suck at the game, but I personally really like it, so...
Some
dickhead
laughed at me.
I actually found it really tough. I might need a bit more practice, but yeah, it seems like a really fun like an arcade style game. So really fun, yeah. I like it. Sorry about his drunk pickup video, guys. Yeah. God. How long this went on for anyway?
Oh shit. Right, go on.
Probably about 2 hours.
It's nine minutes already, right?
Drunk.
This is going to be close to half an hour.
Oh,
God, mate.
Some people just got out of the car.
What?
People won't know what I'm going about. I'm playing Saints Row 2, so I'm a bit distracted at the moment.
Yeah, he's playing Saints Row 2 on the PS3. Which I probably should buy sometime, to be honest. Yeah. You got anything to say to that? Should I buy Saints Row 2 or 3 or whatever?
People in the house say, yeah!
Yeah!
Don't say no!
So anyway, we'll go on to the next set of pickups, which are two games from a series on the PS2 that I got out of YMCA. What's YMCA? Don't sing. Wait. yeah.
That's a shop.
Well, YMCA, yeah. It's young men.
Great choice of name.
It's young men's Christian Society or something like that.
What a choice of name.
Yeah, YMCA. Awesome. Anyway, these are two games.
Welcome to the country meeting. We're now here to discuss our financial reasons. What do we have for YMCA?
Oh no, he's off. Right, anyway. These are two games I got on the PS2 from a series which I really like. I'm a big fan of this series. Even though I've only played the second game, but I actually really love it and I'm really glad to get the first game as well. Here we have Kingdom Hearts. So this is the first one, and also at the same charity shop for $1.99, which you also already have, is Kingdom Hearts 2. Right, so I'll get to that and why I got that in a minute. But anyway, it's Kingdom Hearts 1, the Platinum version, in really good condition, I must say. Manuals almost mint, and discs, we've got one tiny scratch, but apart from that, in excellent condition. And I played it for about 2 hours. And seems really good. I really enjoyed the second one, but you know, I think I'll enjoy this one just as much, to be honest. So I'm really glad to get this game, and for $1.99, it's a bargain. I have to grab it, didn't I? So yeah, and the reason why I rebought Kingdom Hearts 2 was basically because my manual disc is pretty scratched, and my manual is it's quite ruffled. So I took a pot look at this game, and the manual's ruffled, but the disc is in a lot better condition than mine. It's only got like one scratch in it, so it's a lot better condition than mine. So what I'm gonna do is swap the discs over, or keep this version or whatever, and then sell one on eBay, probably, to be honest.
Ruffled.
So yeah, Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2, blooming awesome games. I would love these games. I'd love a Kingdom Hearts 3 on the PS3. That would make my day. It would make my bloody day.
You always
want
to ruffle it.
Oh God. And the next.
Oh God.
Anyway, the next game is also on the PS2. I got this the same day as Heart of Darkness from some. I think it was some Animal Trust or something, some Animal Trust charity. Yeah. And this one is Dragon Guard. Drakengard. Yeah. Drakengard. I actually took potluck with this. I got this for £2 as well. I didn't actually think I would enjoy it. What caught my attention was obviously being Square Enix. You know, Square Enix, they do make some like good RPGs. I really like them, you know. They make, you know, Final Fantasy, Kingdom Hearts, you know, you name it. They make some really awesome games. So, I don't actually often see this game. I don't know, it's probably not rare or anything, but I don't often see this game, so I decided just to grab it when I could. And I actually thought it was going to... What are you talking about? Silence. I actually thought it was going to be like Dynasty Warriors.
Are you talking to me?
No. Hell no.
I'm too busy concentrating on this mission.
You concentrate on that mission, mate. Good luck to you. Probably.
People haven't turned off yet by now because I'm so annoying.
I know. You probably talk more than me. Nah, probably not.
And you're the drunk one.
I'm a drunk one, yeah. I can't wait to actually like watch this video back tomorrow and see what it's like. But anyway, it's getting uploaded, whether it's good or shit or whatever the hell it is. Anyway, yeah, dropping a typical risk. I thought it was going to win Dynasty Warriors, which it is kind of, but I feel it's a lot less repetitive. I played it for about an hour, and surprisingly, I really enjoyed it. That was a real surprise for me. I didn't think I was going to enjoy it as much as I did, so... Yeah, Drakengard on the PS2. Awesome.
Yes,
not you. You fail, man. You fail. Wait.
I'll have a break on Instagram. I can't do it.
Play a game that you're good at. One Nation Racer!
One Nation Racer!
Oh, God. Yeah, One Nation Racers, man. You're good at that. Oh, we always kick my ass there, anyway.
When you're sober as well.
I know. Oh, God, I know. Bloody hell. So, anyway. When I'm sober, yep. Yeah. I'm definitely not sober. Not yet, anyway. we've got two PS games left to show, and my voice has kind of died a bit, actually.
Mine's still Joe Pasquale-like.
I do your impression of Joe Pasquale.
I don't have one.
Eh?
I don't have one.
Oh, do you have a really high voice?
Anyway, enough of
this. Okay, that's fair enough.
Don't judge me!
Alright, so we got on to these last two PS2 games then. This one is a game that I used to have when I first got the PS2. It was like the fifth game or sixth game that I got. And I actually sold it later on because I found it like really tough for some reason.
Wah,
wah. Wah, wah, wah. But I played it again recently. Well, like I bought it recently. And I think it's a really good game, and I've basically seen this game in a lot of charity shops lately since it came out on PSN. I think it's like £7 on PSN, but the game is Max Payne.
Yeah.
And hold on guys, I need to BRB. Right, anyway, we're continuing, I'm sorry guys, I have to go for a pee, I was bursting to be honest.
Yeah, I have to
go for a pee. I don't know if I said what it was. I don't know where I was, to be honest. Max Payne on the PS2. Yeah, ever since this came out on the PSN, it's been like everywhere. It's been like in three different charity shops that I've been to. So I had to pick it up eventually. And for $1.99,
you said that you apparently saw this lots of times in charity shops.
Yeah.
And you didn't buy it the first time you saw it? Oh, everyone, nah. Let's just hate on him right now. Let's just hate on him right now.
The first
time you saw it, you didn't buy it. The second time you saw it, you didn't buy it. Oh, that's it. I am unsubbing right now. Can't believe
it. I didn't buy it the first time either.
Oh, man, I can't believe you. Hate is gonna hate.
Oh, dear.
Come at him,
bros! Come at him! Yeah, I should really have bought it the first time I saw it, to be honest.
I'm so drunk.
I know, God! Anyway, yeah. So I had this when I first got it, when I first got the PS2, but I sold it because I found it really tough. But like I say, going back to it recently, it's a really good game. Man. It's got like a good fan base as well, the first two games. I don't know about the third game.
It's a huge cult following, yeah.
It's got a good following.
Probably as big as Labyrinth, the movie.
Biggest following is Labyrinth, the movie. I've never heard of that, but we're going to go with that anyway.
David Bowie.
David Bowie, oh God, no. Anyway,
I'm not David Bowie.
Anyway, the first part of the game, actually, it was actually quite scary, to be honest. I mean, Max Payne, his house was getting burgled, right? And basically, there's burglars in his house, right? And and basically, you hear it gunshots, right? And
we need a right counter.
Yeah, it's like gunshots, right? Oh God!
Okay.
I wasn't aware of that until you mentioned it. But you hear gunshots, right? And then oh my God.
You hear gunshots left.
I hear gunshots left, right? And then basically you go into a room, right, where his baby daughter is, baby daughter. Oh God. I'll take a giggle and sit. Hold on. You ready?
Yeah.
Right, yeah, sorry about that, guys, I'm back again. So you're going to...
Poker face,
right, okay. So you go into a room, and his baby's in the cot. His baby daughter's in the cot, and obviously the cot's, like, tipped over. And it's like, you know, and she, and the baby's dead in the cot. I actually thought that was pretty sick, to be honest. And this game... Right, and the game...
Wow, really? That's really...
Yeah. And this game's a 15 plus, right?
That's really good.
Yeah.
The dead baby daughter... In a
car, yeah, and the cot's tipped over, yeah.
Oh my god.
That's when I thought the game would be like an, you know, 18 rated game, because that is pretty, sick.
HQ.
Wow.
Rockstar.
That actually creeped me out. I don't know why it creeped me out.
Oh,
and then she goes in. And then he goes in and his wife's dead, while he's dead in the bed. God.
Oh my god.
But the baby got to me. I thought that was creepy as hell. I don't know. Oh god.
Oh, Rockstar, you got me there.
Yeah.
Oh, Rockstar, you.
That was bloody, that was really bloody creepy.
What a twist.
I actually think this game should be an 18 plus because of that.
I've got to see that now.
But yeah, it comes completely manual and a couple of scratches in the disc, but yeah, pretty good condition overall. $1.99, pretty good deal actually. I might play through it and get the second game, but I don't know about the third game, but yeah.
So far, what have you thought of it?
So far, it seems pretty good, but that was brutal at that beginning, but it was brutal. I don't know.
It was
creepy, and it's like the baby's like, you know, the music, the lullaby thing was playing in the background. Oh my god.
Lullaby music with a dead baby on screen in a car.
Oh yeah, exactly. It was creepy.
I've got to see that.
Oh no. Right, anyway. Moving on. This is a game I got today as well. Not played it yet, but I hear it's really good, and for £2, definitely could resist, and it is Ico on the PS2. Now, I know this has recently been, you know, released as a HD collection thing along with Shadow of the Colossus. But for £2, you know, I couldn't resist when I saw this in a charity shop. So I'm going to play this. I might play through it. Yeah, nice, exactly, nice. I might play through it, and if I like it, I'll probably buy the HD remake of it, or the HD version of it. Pardon me. The HD version of it, along with Shadow of the Colossus. So yeah, and I'll probably sell this on eBay, because I think it goes for like £6 or £7 on. So yeah, Ico, really glad to get that, and I'm actually really really excited to play this game. So Ico, yeah. Right, so before I get to the non-gaming pickups, I've got something to say on, I never actually mentioned this, but on Steam, basically, Steam, I sometimes buy games now and again on Steam. And I bought one like 2 months ago, I never mentioned it. It was a Shatter, which is actually a really good game, Shatter. It's basically, you've got a bat and you've got like a ball. And it's kind of like Pong, but it's like a, I don't know. It's like a...
Wait, whoa. Shatter's on Steam?
Yeah. You don't know that, mate.
Why have you never told me about this? You never told me you got Shatter on Steam.
Yeah, it was like £2 fet or something. It had a special offer for
it.
I think I've upset him now.
$6.99 now.
Yeah, it was like £2 fet or something, so I got it when it was an offer.
Fucking
awesome! It's actually a really, really good game. It's like an updated version of, like, you know, a breakout game, I would say. Not Pong. I would say it's more like a breakout game. But, of course, you get like, power-ups and stuff. And I tell you something, the music on Shutter is absolutely amazing. I actually love it. And you love it as well, don't you?
It is a great game. Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, and the soundtrack's real good as well, eh?
PS3, Steam, totally worth it. Either one is totally worth it. Whatever one you get it on.
Yeah, definitely.
Worth the money.
Yeah.
£6.99, £2, doesn't matter. Worth it.
Yep. Yeah, definitely. It's definitely worth it, I would say. It's a really, really, really fun game. I love it, to be honest. And also a game I got last week, which I've not actually played yet. I got it for 74 pence, so I couldn't really resist. And that was Wolf... Well, oh, I forgot the name. Wolfenstein 3D, yeah.
God.
Wolfenstein 3D.
What a cheeky bastard.
For 74 pence. That was a bargain.
74 pence.
Yeah, 74 pence.
That's like a dollar or two.
Yeah, awesome. It's amazing. Good, great price. One of the main reasons what influenced me to get that game was, of course, it was 74 pence, but that's not the main reason. The main reason was because it looks like Doom. I believe Doom was like inspired by Wolfenstein. Is that correct,
It was Wolfenstein 3D and then Doom.
Yeah, so basically Doom kind of like was influenced by, Wolfenstein 3D, which obviously caught my attention because, I really love the look of Doom, So I really, when it's 74 pence, I just grabbed it, to be honest. couldn't resist it, to be honest. Yeah, I couldn't resist it, to be honest. So I can't wait to play that. I'm looking forward to playing it. I should play it this week sometime. Hopefully I get around to it. That's the Steam games. Now, for the non-gaming pickups. How long is this video anyway?
About
26 minutes.
Oh! I just saw the baby thing on that.
Did you see it? We didn't care.
Oh my god. That's crappy. And there's like two men in there as well that you got killed.
Yeah, it's pretty sick.
One can only imagine what those two men did to a baby before they killed it. Oh.
No, dude.
Oh my god.
Dude. Anyway.
Wow. Really? Really?
Yes, really. God. Right. We'll quickly do the non-gaming pickups, and then we'll...
I do apologise for that. You can continue now.
Thank you. I'm glad to have your permission to continue. Right, anyway. So I got this today, right? It was, it's brand new, right? It's sealed. I think this could be worth a lot of money in the future, and it is a Colgate toothbrush. Did I have
it? Ah,
a Colgate toothbrush, right?
Oh my god.
But it's sealed though, it's brand new, it's sealed. I like to have a laugh. Anyway, my toothbrush is getting a bit worn, so I bought a new one. Hooray! And it was only 49 pence, wait, anyway. Cheaper than Wolfenstein, yeah, hell yeah. And I got this this deodorant stuff, which I've actually never used before. And it's a part of an Aquatonic Man. I don't know how dark this video is, to be honest, but it is Aquatonic Man.
It's
got a nice smell actually, but I don't know. It's a cheap deodorant, so we'll see if it works.
Right now, on video, I want you to spray your toothbrush and brush your teeth.
No.
Deodorant toothpaste.
No, but anyway. My granny bought me this, okay? As you all know, the Hearts and Hibs Scottish Cup final was, Was it last week? See, I'm drunk. I don't even know the date. Yeah, it was last week. And Hearts, of course, beat Hibs. Hooray. It was 5-1. Didn't expect it. But she bought me this. Hold on. Oh, shit. It's a poster! It's a Hearts poster for the Scottish Cup final thing. So it's something to keep, as you all know, anyway, you probably don't know. So that's Jamie McDonald, who the hell is that? Hamill, Jamie Hamill, Craig Beatty, Zalukas, sorry, and Ian Block. So it's a pretty nice poster, that, actually. It's something in the cape.
What? What are you
going to
do with it?
Might put it in my wall, I don't know. I was going to put it in my wall, but I'm not really sure, to be honest.
You're on the ceiling.
I'm on the ceiling.
And pretend you're in a dentist.
A dentist with pirates posters.
Yeah, still those. I don't know what other dentists have, but the one that I go to have these dogs on the ceiling.
Really?
Dogs with big heads.
No, it's just that video. Yeah. Alright, fair enough. Oh well. Do you have any last words, by the way, man?
I'd be surprised if people are still watching this up to this point because of me, my annoyingness, and goodbye, don't die.
It has been like 31 minutes long, you know.
I wouldn't be surprised. By the way, Andrew.
Hello?
Ready?
Yeah.
Do you like CM Punk?
I like CM Punk.
People don't know what that'll mean.
Probably not, Matt. I like CM Punk. Okay, is that it again? Anyway. And your last word is?
Kongaroo.
That's a bit random, but alright, fair enough.
It's a word, I suppose.
I suppose. Anyway, guys, thanks for what is your last word?
I beg your pardon. No one in your audience is
going to
understand what that means.
I don't even bother to understand what that means. Oh my god. Is that, wait now, is that Klonoa?
What?
Is that Klonoa, Nat?
Klonoa?
Yeah,
Klonoa.
It sounds a bit like Klonoa's voice. Alright, that's enough. Anyway. Chase your audience away. Anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll catch you all in the next video where I will be sober. Yay. See you guys. Thanks for watching.